Where's my disk space going? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got. Our disk drive is split into a C and a D drive. We only ever save on the D drive, but the C drive has only about 540 megabytes left available. Apart from about 5 gigabytes of photos, I can't understand what's taking up all the disk space. The disk space seems to continually go down and is now getting to a critical level. I've run malware checks and deleted all critical errors, but still have not been able to free up any disk space. I can't even defrag as I need 20% free to run this option. Disappearing disk space is a very common scenario. Somehow, no matter how much we have, disk space never seems enough. As we collect pictures and programs, and the programs themselves collect data, more and more disk space is consumed. With so much happening on our computers these days, it's difficult to understand what's taking up all the space. Fortunately, I can recommend a free tool that can give us some very helpful data. TreeSize Free is a free tool that will show you what's taking up all of the space on your machine. There is a paid version available that's got some additional features, but honestly, for what you're doing, for the kind of problem we're trying to solve here, the free version will suffice. So, let's run TreeSpace Free. Here I am in Windows 11. I'm just going to search for TreeSpace Free. There's the official download, the free download. We download the free version. It's up to you if you want to buy one later. You don't need to. With the download complete, I'm just going to go ahead and open it. And also close the browser at this point since we're done with that. And run through the installation process very quickly. We'll go ahead and create a desktop shortcut. I don't like File Explorer context menus in general, so I'm not going to do that. And it'll be on the Start menu. And there it is. I'm going to go ahead and launch TreeSize Free right now. Now, this is an interesting question. TreeSize Free that we've just installed and run is running as our currently logged in user. It does not have administrative privileges. What that means is it can't necessarily look into every folder across the entire machine. So the alternative is to restart and run the program as administrator. What I'm going to do is actually say, always start as administrator, because I really don't see a reason to run it any other way. And here's the UAC prompt you would expect from the program restarting itself as administrator. So TreeScan, in this example, has scanned our hard drive. If I hit refresh, it'll scan again, and you'll see this little progress circle in the upper right there will indicate that it is or isn't doing something and how far it thinks it has to go. This is a, I'll just call it a typical machine. It's one of my example Windows 11 installations, but you can see right away what's using up space on this machine. Windows is taking up 24.2 gigabytes of this hard drive. Program files and program files 86 are next, 5.9 and 3.6 gigabytes each. Users, which would include my files. So, how can we use this information? What can we do to dig a little deeper, to find out what's going on? Well, the greater than sign in front of each of these things is actually something you can click on that will turn into a downward pointing arrow that expands all of the folders within whatever it was you were looking at. So, for example, Windows, the 24.2 gigabytes of Windows, actually contains all of these folders. You can see that the largest folder within Windows is WinSXS. That is a normal, typical part of Windows. It's actually part of System File Checker and a couple of other things. But you get the idea. You can see here now what each of these subfolders in Windows is taking up. And if you want to, you can dive deeper. Here's what's inside of WinSXX. You can see what each folder, by default, obviously, it's sorting by the largest folders up at the top, so you can see what size each one of those is taking. Now, in this folder, whatever it happens to be, you'll see that there is something here that is not a folder. This is a file. These are the files that exist within that folder. The things below here that have folder icons, those are still subfolders. Those are folders we could continue to dive into. But this icon represents, in this case, 418 megabytes in 49 files that live in this specific folder. And sure enough, if I want to, I can expand that and I can see all of the specific file names and how big they are. So that, honestly, not all that interesting. That's Windows. What most people are interested in is user files, the files that are associated with your user account. So we'll expand users. We will expand the currently logged in user. You'll want to know which one you're at. This machine has two users on it, Leon, which is a local machine account, and askle, which is actually the first five characters of the Microsoft account that's used to log into that account. If I expand Leon, you can see that it's app data now that has 1.3 gigabytes representing the vast majority of the space being used by the Leon user. And of course, like I said, you can dig down into these. Local is next, then Microsoft is next, OneDrive is next, and yep, it's got stuff in it that we don't necessarily care about. The point here is that you can use this now to find out exactly what is taking up space. What's taking up space on your machine? I can't know. However, using a tool like TreeSize, you can quickly dive down into what's taking up space. And once you find out what that is, perhaps with a little bit of research, you could understand what it is, why it's there, and if there's appropriate action you can take. Now, I have to throw in an aside. The original question did not ask about disk space. The original question was asking about memory. They were talking about disk space, but they used the term memory. People confuse these terms a lot, and unfortunately, it's incredibly important, especially when you're asking for help, that you use the terms correctly. To oversimplify just a little, memory is the RAM, random access memory, in which your programs and the data reside when they are in use. When you turn your computer off, your RAM is erased. To free up memory, run fewer programs at the same time. Disk space is all about your hard drive, where data is stored permanently or until you or a program explicitly erases it. To free up disk space, you erase files. Another good difference to note is size. My personal laptop, for example, has 16 gigabytes of memory, but a terabyte, 1,024 gigabytes of disk space. Disk space on a machine is almost always much greater than its RAM. So, if you find yourself running low on disk space and you've taken all the steps you know of to free up more, a tool like TreeSize is a quick and easy way to determine what's taking up so much space. With that answer in hand, you can then take targeted action. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3173. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.